Why have you stopped communicating?
No stop. Others. Hidden, covered. Secret, fear. The alien could not communicate with them because they were afraid of her or do not trust her. And it is clear to me that the alien is very aware that some people have secret intentions toward her and are hiding their real thoughts. It is equally obvious to me that the alien does not have even a tiny bit of fear of us, or anything else, for that matter.
Can you read or write any Earth languages?
No.
Do you understand numbers or mathematics?
Yes. I am officer, pilot, engineer.
Can you write or draw symbols or pictures that we may be able to translate into our own language?
Uncertain.
Are there any other signs or means of communication you can use to help us understand your thoughts more clearly?
No.
Can you show us on a map of the stars which is the star of your home planet?
No. This is not because she does not know the directions from Earth to her home planet. She was unwilling to reveal the location. It was also due to the fact that the star system of her home planet does not exist on any star map on Earth. It is too far away.
How long will it take your people to locate you here?
Unknown.
How long would it take your people to travel here to rescue you?
Minutes or hours.
How can we make them understand that we do not intend to harm you?
Intentions are clear. See in your mind, images, feelings.
If you are not a biological entity, why do you refer to yourself as feminine?
I am a creator, mother, source. These questions took me only a few minutes to complete. I realized then that we may be in for some serious trouble if the alien was not willing to cooperate or reveal any information that the military or intelligence agencies or scientists consider to be useful to them. I was also sure that the alien was very certain of the actual intentions of the people who wrote these questions, as she could read their minds just as easily as she could read my thoughts and communicate with me telepathically. Because of these intentions, she was unwilling and unable to cooperate with any of them in any way, under any circumstances. I am equally sure that since she was not a biological life form, that there was no kind of torture or coercion that would change her mind.
What assurance or proof do you require from us that will make you feel safe enough to answer our questions?
Only she speaks. Only she hears. Only she questions. No others. Must learn. No. Understand. John Newbel, who was a Japanese language specialist from the Navy, had an explanation and a solution to the problem. He explained that, first, the problem had very little to do with the inability of the alien to communicate. It had more to do with her unwillingness to communicate with anyone other than myself. Second, in order for any clear, comprehensive communication to happen, both parties needed to understand and communicate through a common language. The language specialist suggested that I take several children's books and a basic reading primer and grammar text with me into the interview room. The plan was that I would sit next to the alien and read aloud to her from the books, while pointing to the text I was reading with my finger so that she could follow along. The theory was that the alien could eventually be taught to read, just as a child is taught to read by word and sound association with the written word, as well as instruction in fundamental grammar. I returned to the interview room and proposed this idea to Iril. She did not object to learning the language, although she did not make any commitment to answer questions either. No one else had a better idea, so we went ahead. I began the reading lessons with the first pages of a school book that had been used to teach pioneer children in the 1800s on the frontiers of America. It is called McGuffey's Eclectic Reader, Primer through Sixth. Since I am a nurse and not a teacher, the language expert who gave me the books also gave me an extensive briefing, a course that took an entire day on how to use the books to teach the alien. By the 15th day after rescuing Iril from the crash site, I was able to communicate fluidly and effortlessly with her in English. She had absorbed so much written material by this time that her academic education far exceeded my own. Although I graduated from high school in Los Angeles in 1940 and attended college for 4 years of pre-medical and nursing training, the variety of my own reading had been fairly limited. What would you like to say, Iril? I asked.
I have been a part of the Domain Expeditionary Force in this sector of space for several thousand years. However, I have not personally had intimate contact with beings on Earth since 5965 BCE. It is not my primary function to interact with inhabitants of planets within the domain. I am an officer, pilot, and engineer, with many duties to perform. Nonetheless, although I'm fluent in 347 other languages within the domain, I have not been exposed to your English language. The last Earth language with which I was conversant was the Sanskrit language of the Vedic hymns. At that time I was a member of a mission sent to investigate the loss of a domain base located in the Himalaya Mountains. An entire battalion of officers, pilots, communications and administrative personnel disappeared and the base destroyed. Several million years ago I was trained and served as an investigation, data evaluation and program development officer for the domain. Because I was experienced in that technology, I was sent to Earth as part of the search team. One of my duties involved interrogation of the human population that inhabited the adjoining area at that time. Many of the people in that region reported sighting Vimanas or spacecraft in the area. Following the logical extension of evidence, testimony, observation, as well as the absence of certain evidence, I led my team to the discovery that there were still old empire ships and well-hidden old empire installations in the solar system, of which we had been completely unaware. You and I were unable to communicate in your language because I, personally, have not been exposed to your language. However, now that I have scanned the books and material you provided me, this data has been relayed to our space station in this region and processed by our communications officer through our computers. It has been translated into my own language and relayed back to me in a context that I can think with. I have also received additional information from the files stored in our computers about the English language and domain records concerning Earth civilization. Now I am prepared to give you certain information that I feel will be of great value to you. I will tell you the truth. Although truth is relative to all other truth, I wish to share with you as honestly and accurately as possible, truth as I see it, within the boundaries of my integrity to myself, to my race, and without violating my obligations to the organization I serve, and have sworn to uphold and protect.
Okay, I thought. Will you answer questions from the gallery now?
No. I will not answer questions. I will provide information to you that I think will be beneficial to the well-being of the immortal spiritual beings who comprise humanity, and that will foster the survival of all the myriad life forms and the environment of Earth, as it is a part of my mission to ensure the preservation of Earth. Personally, it is my conviction that all sentient beings are immortal spiritual beings. This includes human beings. For the sake of accuracy and simplicity, I will use a made-up word. Is B. Because the primary nature of an immortal being is that they live in a timeless state of is, and the only reason for their existence is that they decide to be. No matter how lowly their station in a society, every isbe deserves the respect and treatment that I myself would like to receive from others. Each person on earth continues to be an isbe whether they are aware of the fact or not.
Only three things happen every day thereafter. 1. Arrow resolutely refused to answer any questions that she sensed had been posed by or suggested to me by the gallery, the staff. 2. Errol continued to instruct me in subject matter of her own choice. 3. Every evening after my interview with or instruction from Errol, she would give me a new list of subject matter about which she wanted more information. Each evening I presented this list to the gallery. The next day Errol received a large stack of books, magazines, articles, and so forth. She would study all of these during the night, while I slept. This pattern repeated every day during the remainder of the time I spent with her. The subject matter of my next interview, or lesson, from Iroh continued with a brief history of Earth, our solar system, and nearby space, from the perspective of the domain